such kind of career option where there will be power, where there will be prestige, where there will be, you can say, respect from the society. Any kind, such kind of career option you want to, you have to tell me via this chat box. Okay, Shubham, very good. IAS is career option. Okay, any other career option? IPS, okay. Civil services. So of course, you can say that pandemic is there, lockdown is there. We are suffering this lockdown and our country has suffered due to this. So you can say that, but government has not suffered. Government work is going on. Government is working efficiently. Officers are working efficiently. So you can say this is one of the best career option, which is not dependent on any external factors. So all of you, whatever you're telling is absolutely correct. Then, now I would like to tell you that how many of you are 12th pass here, 12th examination you have just given and you have passed. So how many of you, just you can raise your hand. 12th pass. Yes. Okay. Okay. So this webinar is there for 12th pass students as well as who are already graduates. So for both the types of students, we are delivering this webinar. So I welcome all of you on behalf of A. Shah Institute. And this institute, if you can search it on a Google, so you are at a perfect place, that this is one of the top institutes in Mumbai, you can say, for civil services preparation. And I'll be taking you through the journey from how I cannot to how I can. So today's theme is there. See, what is the problem? Problem is that whenever we talk about government jobs, whenever we talk about UPSC examination, MPSC examination, IAS, IPS, it is very easy to talk. But the problem is that many students also think that it is a very difficult thing. So we are going to counter it today, that how I cannot to I can. So this will be our journey in this today's webinar. Okay. So I welcome all of you. Now I am uploading my PPT. Yeah. So I have uploaded the presentation. So it will take a couple of minutes. Have patience. See, students, patience is very important. From the context of this patience, I can say that if you want to become civil services officers or top level officers, then patience carries a big role in that. So first, studies, okay. You need to think about the studies, how to study, what to study. We are there to guide you. But first of all, you need to understand how to develop the patience. That is the prime most important thing. Okay, how to develop the patience. That is prime most important thing. Now the PPT is getting loaded. So apart from that, so first you talk about that, one of the best career option is civil services, which is not dependent on any other external factors. Now, can I ask you the question, what is the difference between private job and what is the difference between civil services related, whatever service you'll be giving to the country or to the state? What is the difference between that? What is the difference between private job and what is the difference between civil services career option? You can talk me, you can interact with me via voice. No problem. Yeah, difference between private job and civil services careers. Can you tell me? Our PPT is getting uploaded. Yes, students, chat box, you can answer me. You need to be interactive, okay? See, I would like to tell you that if you are interactive, you can really beat any battle, provided that you are interactive. Job security, very good. See, first of all, job is not a correct word. See, forget about the job. Okay, job is not a correct word. You are going to civil services officer. So job is improper word. First of all, remove that job mentality from your head. If you are exploring for the jobs, there are a lot of jobs available in the market and there are other examinations also, public sector jobs that you can give. But if you want to become civil services, if you want to become IAS level officers, IPS level officers, then remove that job mentality. You are not here to get the job. Okay, so job security, there are lots of jobs available in the market. So first of all, forget about that job mentality. Then, so any other aspect? Of course, job security is there. Okay, your differentiation factor is correct, but you need not consider that job security in your mind before preparing this examination. So, okay, one is the job security. Any other aspect, private job and civil services job, what is the difference? What are the plus? What are the minuses? Will serve country and a lot of respect in a very good. That is the point which I was looking for. So you will be serving the country ultimately. In a private job, who you are serving? You are serving a private organization, a private company, where owner is personal, where owner is a family, where owner is an elite family. They are not contributing anything for the nation. Okay, but via civil services, you are directly contributing to the nation. You are directly contributing to the public of this nation. That's what is called as civil services. You are giving services. Okay, then passion for serving the entire nation. Okay, passion is, of course, passion is there, and government will take care of you, students. If you are passionate, if you are eager to serve your country, government will take care of you 100 times more than any private job. Even if you are a manager, even if you are a CEO in a private job, government is going to take care of you. Okay, then we serve country and a lot of respect. Of course, that respect will be there, prestige will be there, passion for serving the entire nation, earning in every field, but here is earning with dignity. Of course, see, you cannot replace your identity, you cannot replace your respect, whatever you are getting from the society, with the money. You cannot measure it in terms of money and salaries. Okay, people are going to respect you, your identification is going to be there into the society, people are going to recognize you, not only you but your family, your relatives, people are going to recognize and give respect. So this is the thing which you cannot measure in terms of money or in terms of salaries. So absolutely correct point. Be the change we want to see in the governance. Very good. So Mahatma Gandhi's slogan was there: be the change you want to see into the society. Be the change you want to become. So if you want to change this nation, if you want to change the system, then you need to become part of this system, as per the Mahatma Gandhi slogan: be the change you want to become. So very good. So Shubham, your sentence reminded me of that great sentence from Mahatma Gandhi. So very good. I like your answers, and your answers itself shows that you are very much passionate for your civil services careers. And I assure you, you are at the perfect and right place. Satisfaction. Yeah, of course, satisfaction is always there. What you have done for your country, ultimately, what you are doing for your country, what you have done for the society, that is a question mark at the end of a private job. So if this question you are asking yourself when you are into the civil services, this question will give you self-satisfaction. Okay, so satisfaction will be there, respect will be there, power will be there. So we are going through our slides. So I again welcome all of you. Then, so as Nelson Mandela says, he's a great leader. You can say that it always seems impossible until it is done. See, there is a journey. Everything you might have done in your career, it might have been always seem impossible. Okay, I cannot do that. It seems very difficult. I don't think I would be able to do that. I have some limitations. I have some resources constraints, so I will not able to do that. But at least one in your life, it might have happened that, okay, you were initially thinking about that, you cannot do that, but you have ultimately did that. At least one thing you might have done in your career. This. So my friends, believe that this is a very much, you can say, relevant with your life, not only about studies, but other life challenges also. So you should always remember this slogan: it always seems impossible until it's done finally. Okay, then next thing. So I would like to tell you that first we would be playing a game, a quick game we will be playing. Okay, so my first question to you is, you can quickly draw this diagram in your notebook, or if your visual power is good, you can think about that visual power. Okay, let's think about your aptitude. Okay, you all might be having knowledge, you all might be having a very studious persona, or you might be reading the books, but let's check your aptitude also. And can you tell that, can you see this diagram, all of you? Interact via chat box. Please quickly draw this diagram in your notebook, quickly draw this diagram on a blank page. Okay, yes. So 2 minutes, 2 to 3 minutes game we are playing, a small game. Via that game I want to tell you something. Okay, so you can interact with me via your voice also. Okay, if you cannot able to show me the diagram, you can at least interact via voice, no problem. So my first question to you is, can you see the four squares in this diagram? You need to interact, students. Your chats are not coming smoothly, so you need to ensure that you are interacting. So can you see these four squares over here? Look carefully to the diagram. Now I will be asking you four questions about this square. Okay, yes. So my first question to you is, so listen carefully, see carefully. Okay, so divide the white portion A. Can you see white portion A over here? Can you see white portion A? You can see white portion A over here. So divide the white portion A into two equal parts. This is a white portion, okay, not a shaded portion. Can you see this corner? This corner you need to divide into two equal parts. How can you divide it? You can interact orally also. Portion A, this elbow you need to divide into two equal parts. Yeah, you can chat also. Yes, someone is typing. I'm eager to know the answers from you. You can talk also, students. Drawing a diagonal line, very good. You can draw a diagonal like this. I'm showing you. I know, obviously you can, all of you can give this answer. So diagonal line I'll be drawing like this. Can you able to see this diagonal line? Okay, from this point to this point I'll be drawing a diagram. So you can divide portion A in two equal parts. Very good, you have answered correctly. So this is what it was expected. Okay, you can see the answer. Now you will be able to see the answer, which all of you have given correctly. Fine. See, this is what you talk about, right? So all of you are correct. Now my second question. Now second question is getting loaded. You need to divide the portion B now. Portion B in three equal parts. See, divide the white area in square B into three equal parts. So white area in square B, you can see, you need to divide in three equal parts. There is a big moral behind that game. So don't think that, sir, why you are taking this? We are here to prepare for the civil services, and what you are taking these games and all. So there is one moral behind that I want to tell you. Yeah, can you chat or can you tell me how can you divide portion B in three equal parts? Again, not a very challenging question, but might be difficult for some people. Portion B, that elbow you need to divide in three equal parts. Adding more three boxes in the B part. Okay, adding more three boxes in the B part. How you can add but? How you can add but? Drawing three squares in part B. Yeah, three squares in part B. But how? You need to increase this length. Yes, you are correct. You need to increase this length and you need to increase this length, right? Then you can interact into three equal parts. Three equal parts, you can increase this length also. Okay, understood? So that way it will be. Very good. So all of you might have done the answer correctly. So you can see the solution over here. That way, right? That way you wanted to tell that we'll be increasing that length and we'll be increasing the horizontal length and vertical length, and we will be dividing that white portion of that square into three equal parts. Fine. Okay, now the next challenge is coming. Okay, now the next challenge is coming. How you can answer, you can tell me. Okay, so now the next challenge is coming, the diagram number three. Okay, so you have answered it correctly. Now the portion C, you can see the portion, divide the white area in a square C into four equal pieces. In four equal pieces, you need to divide the white portion of the portion C. How it is possible now? How you will be doing that? White portion of C in four equal pieces. Is it challenging? Image sharing is not possible. No problem. Yes, can you tell me orally? You can also tell if you are getting difficulty in writing, then you can tell me orally also. Four equal pieces, how it is possible? Yeah, can't you interact via your voice, students? So I would be getting a better response. Yeah, Pratham Vaish, Pratham, can you tell me how can you divide it into four equal parts? He seems offline. Shubham, can you tell me how you can divide it into four equal parts? Yes, more messages are there. Yeah, only white portion, only white portion. Mixing mixed line A and B. Okay, mixed line set of A and B. No, sorry. Do we have to divide the white portion only? No. Only white portion you need to divide, not a black portion. Okay, I will be telling you the answer for this also. See, that way you can divide it into four equal parts. Is it adding four triangles from the diagonals? No, it is not like a four triangles. Can you see this diagram? You have divided that unshaded portion of C in four equal parts like this. So first one was easy, second one was little bit difficult, third one is extremely difficult. Now the most difficult question is coming. Now the most difficult question is coming, and you need to answer me in 7 seconds, 7 to 10 seconds. You need to answer me to the next question. Okay, so all of you are convinced how four equal parts we are doing here? All of you are convinced how we are dividing it into four equal parts? Yes or no? Yes, tell me yes or no. I have divided unshaded portion of scene. Was it a creative one? What is it, a creative one? Yeah, it was. Of course, it was a creative. Now the best question, now the difficult question is coming. Just pay attention. Last question, in 1 minute it will take. So divide unshaded portion of D in 7 equal parts. Divide unshaded portion of D in 7 equal parts. Yes, you can interact via orally. You can interact orally also. 7 equal parts. It seems, just tell me in the chat box, is it easy or is it difficult? I just want the answer. Is it easy or difficult? Only that thing. I'm not bothered about your answers. Are you able to do it into 7 equal parts or not? I'm not bothered about that. Yeah. Pratham Visharia, can you tell me how it is easy? 7 equal parts. That is the last question before we come to the conclusion of this puzzle. And students, believe me, this is one of the questions which has been asked in actual interview of civil services. This question was there in, I guess, 2003. This question was there in one of the interview. Easy, how? Can you just elaborate within some fraction of seconds? Within some seconds, can you elaborate how it is easy? Drawing 7 straight lines in the main bigger square. Okay, nice. So, great answer from Pratham Visharia. So, see, students, I just wanted to tell you that how the mentality goes. Now, see, it was so easy. It was so easy. See, just drawing the 7 equal parts, just drawing the 7 lines like this, right? So, I want to tell you that your mentality might have happened, ki, okay, sir, first question was easy, second question was little bit difficult, third question was extremely difficult, and you expected that next question, whatever was coming, that is question number 4, must be very difficult, and you just could not think about that. Okay, but that's question number 4 was actually very easy. So that mentality, I wanted to tell you that you need to nurture that mentality of negative mentality. See, every question is a fresh question. Every situation is a fresh situation, and you need to counter that situation. Okay, so you don't have to depend on the previous mentalities. Okay, I was a very dumb student in question. I'm just telling you the moral of this. I was a very dumb student in my 10th standard, and how I can do the IAS examination. I had got very less marks in 12th standard. How I can prepare for IAS examination? So that sort of negative mentality you need to get rid of. Okay, that question number 4 was extremely easy. That was an easiest question, but you perceive that it was a very difficult question because your past references what was talking that question number 1 was easy, second was difficult, third was extremely difficult, fourth must be very difficult. So this is what happens with our life also. We think that, okay, I have just seen the failures, I have seen the less marks in my past, so I will not be able to do this. And there are some, you can say, why I cannot do it? Why you cannot do IAS examination? Why you cannot crack UPSC or MPSC examination? Because there are some negative aspects. First aspect is, it is very tough examination. I am an average student. It is not my cup of tea. I am from science background. How I can do this? There is no one to guide me. I have no interest in politics. I am a girl. Is it safe for me to join the civil services? Many kind of negative aspects, negative situation comes in your mind whenever you think about that civil services career. So these are some, see, lots of thousands of questions are there, but these are some example point of view. I have taken those questions. So first of all, come out of your negative mentality. So first myth is that it is a very tough examination. Why you cannot do this? Why I cannot do it? See, our today's session is about I cannot to I can. So there is one rational approach. We are not here to tell you the dreamy lines and very cheesy lines and regarding that key, you will be getting, we will be giving you and all those things. Not like that. We are telling you logically how it is possible. So first question was, okay, is it really difficult? UPSC and civil services is very difficult examination and that's why I cannot do that. This is the first major, this is the first student talking about. So definitely that attitude is important. I can attitude is very important before cracking this examination. Before study or before working hard for your examination, it is very important to prepare mentally. To prepare yourself mentally is very important. And for that, I can attitude is very important. IQ comes secondary. Believe me, as far as civil services examination is there, mental power is very much important. Mental power. So your I can attitude is going to help you. And we are here to develop that attitude into you. Yes, I can. Okay, so IQ is okay. IQ, you can say that this examination is not much dependent on memory. Okay, this examination is not very much dependent on memory, like the way your school and colleges examinations used to be. So there is this difference in this competitive exam and your school and college examinations. So how to develop that attitude? We are here. Experienced team is there. I am associated with this institute since last one decade. So I see what kind of faculties come here, how they are guiding to the students, what kind of, you can say, perseverance they are taking for the students, what kind of, you can say, hard work they are taking for the students. So we are here to develop that attitude. Yes, I can. And your hard work and our guidance will give you conviction that yes, you can do this. And of course, some qualities are required from you. Okay, studies, you might be average, you might be above average, you might be excellent, you might not be excellent. That is the second part. First of all, your attitude is very important. Okay, you should work sincerely. You should have interest into this examination. You should have data and you need proper guidance. And we are here for that last thing. Proper guidance, we are there. But before that, you need to develop these qualities into you. Interest, sincerity, strategy, and dedication. If you, even if you are average in studies, you can become an IAS officer or a civil services officer if you have these qualities in you. Okay, then. So next part is that first your integrity and what are needed. Okay, so we are going to now see. This is what the journey we will be taking you through. No, paper pattern is going to take. See, you are too much prejudgmental. Okay, this is very much prejudgmental. I have a total of around 20 slides are there and even a half an hour is there. So you need to have patience, guys. You need to have patience. Okay, Mr. Ibrahim, you are going to see everything. You are going to get everything which we have committed. Okay, so you just have some patience. So this is what the journey will be taking through. I won't do this, so I can do this. I won't. First of all, many questions, many students, my parent might have sent you in this webinar that then you might be thinking that, okay, I will not able to do this, but then I can do it. I want to do it. How do I do it? I'll try to do it. I can do it. I will do it. And yes, I did it. You will be going through that journey. You will be passing through that journey. And we are here to take you through this valuable journey. So you just need to remember this roadmap. And how that roadmap is developed? That roadmap is developed via your attitude. If your attitude is there, you can go through this journey and you can become a winner in this particular journey. Now, coming to the formal points, what Mr. Ibrahim has wanted. Now you'll be getting some slides and all. So college career, I will be talking about that. So UPSC, what is UPSC? UPSC is Union Public Service Commission, a constitutional body granted by Government of India. That you can get it anywhere. You can get this information. Now, so important thing is that UPSC, what you will be getting via civil services, power, social prestige, and what kind of facilities are there that you can always get information. This is a snapshot of the facilities. What kind of facilities you will be getting? Study leaves are there. You can say foreign vehicle store, foreign study tours, and all those aspects will be there. Okay. Study leaves where government will be promoting you. Government will be telling you to take get a scholarship to get into the foreign universities. It will be, government will be there for each and every aspect for your life. So a very nice lifestyle, a very nice facilities are given by the government for any civil services officers. Okay, power and social prestige is most important part in that, which we all have already talked about. Then now many students ask, sir, what is the salary and what are the facilities a civil service officers get? You can say that, you can see the salary figures. Salary figures are, as a cabinet secretary grade, you will be getting around 2,25,000 salaries. Around 2,25,000 salary you will be getting, 6th pay and 7th pay commission. Okay, so these are the cutouts from Times of India. This is a 6th pay commission figures. So you can see that what kind of, see, and nobody does this, you can say, examination for from salary point of view. Okay, there is a different perspective. I talk about those perspective. So salary comes secondary. First comes your passion. First comes your country. Next. So again, same thing, salary packages and all. Paper pattern. See, now the point is coming slowly. Okay. So some of you might be already very much motivated and some of you might not be motivated. So first of all, your mentality is important. Okay. So you can say paper pattern and all these, it is available in Google also. Paper pattern, syllabus, all the things are available in Google. For that, you don't have to come in this webinar. Here we are giving you some exclusive thing and you need to think about those exclusivity. What exclusive things we are giving? That you need to understand. And mentality is important. Studies is not important. Believe me, studies come secondary. First, your mentality comes. So paper pattern is there. Everywhere paper pattern changes. Every year paper pattern changes. For that, you need to read the notifications. Around 35 page notification is there, a PDF notification. You just search it in a Google. You need to, first of all, if you want to prepare for this examination, now first you need to read the notification, students. I tell you, if 100 students are coming that, sir, please guide us for UPSC examination, then out of 100, only 10% students read the notification. The first important aspect to clear direction about the examination, reading the notification is very important. So first, read the notification, upsc.gov.in, or via Google, you will get the PDF notification in that case. Okay? Then, so this is generally the paper pattern. Notification will come, preliminary exam, main exam, personality test. Now, can I ask you, why such kind of paper pattern is there? Why such kind of paper pattern? Why there is not mains exam directly? Why there is preliminary examination? Can you answer via chat box? Why there is a preliminary examination? Or you can interact via voice also. Why preliminary examination? Yes, Zera, come on. To get the deserving candidates. See, not to get the deserving candidates. Okay, your answer. See, to get the deserving candidates will come into the main system. First, not to get undeserving candidates. Not to get undeserving candidates. Not to get undeserving candidates. This is a motive behind preliminary examination. That not to get undeserving candidates. So preliminary examination is for filtration purpose. See, there are many people who talks about the dreams. Sir, I want to become IAS officer. I will serve my country. But the problem is that they are just into their dreams. They are not there to study. They are not studying anything. They are not reading the content. So for that purpose, for filtration purpose, not to select deserving candidates, but to eliminate undeserving candidates, to eliminate the garbage, I will say, to eliminate the garbage. That is a literal word for that. Because the problem is that our country is a famous country for manpower. Our country has got a talented manpower. So there is lot of talent available in India. Even our talent is serving the other countries. But so the problem comes, I want to select the gems. I want to select the best of best people out of so many crores available. For that, preliminary exam is necessary. Filtration is required. You cannot take interview of 5 lakh people and you can select the IAS officers. For that, preliminary examination is necessary. Okay? Exactly. Very good. All the answers are nice. So you need to go through the notification first of all, and then mains examination will be selecting a deserving candidates. Why mains? Because in mains there will be subjective examination. You need to write all the things. Your knowledge will be tested into the main examination. And then finally, your interview via personality test, your interview will be selected in that test. Okay. Okay. Now, next we'll be talking about, the next slide is coming. So you understood the intent behind preliminary examination and the intent behind main examination. Okay. Main examination is completely subjective kind of examination where you need to write. Okay. Now, you don't think about such negative aspect that so many people give the examination and how many get selected. So first of all, I would like to tell you about our, website. First of all, what you do, the first thing, if you want to become IAS officer, now first visit our website, youngias.com. You will get, you can say that as personally, I feel that this is the number one website as far as civil services preparation. The candidates who want to prepare for civil services, this is a number one website, IAS.com. You can just go through the website. So many content, so much of content is available. And not only a content in terms of quantity, but a content in terms of quality is available. So first of all the things are given. Statistics have been given. How many people get selected? What is the male female to get selected into the IAS examination and all? So I would tell you that there are two types of studies. One is direct study and one is indirect study. Can you tell me what is direct study and what is indirect studies? Can you tell me what is direct studies and indirect studies? Anyone? See, what is direct study? Direct study is you are directly reading the book and you are reading the content, you are grasping the content is your direct study. And what is indirect study? That is more important in today's scenario. Indirect studies, you are visiting the website, you are downloading the content, you are downloading the question papers, you are seeing the YouTube, you are getting the information via YouTube, all the things, whatever not directly related studies but which will be supporting your studies is called as indirect studies. Books in the terms of collecting the books, downloading the PDFs of the book, ordering the books online, this will come into your indirect studies. So guys, never first of all, you need to take care of both the aspects. Studies is not only all about reading the books and going through the content. It's not all about the study. Studies is not all about this. Studies, the huge part is played by indirect studies, especially into the civil services examination, where content collection is very important. First, collect the content. Don't directly jump onto the what is the syllabus and I want to read, directly start reading. Don't do like that. First collect the content. First prepare your mind, collect the content, get the resources, and then slowly you start preparing for those examinations. We are here to guide you. All our experts will be guiding you because you are very raw students. You are raw students. Your mentality needs to be prepared. So first, for creating your mentality, see what will happen. Ultimately, it will break down. If you're not mentally prepared, and if we are bombarding you with a syllabus, with your papers and all those things, you will get break. There will be a break point into your mentality. So our experts are there, which will be guiding you via mentally as well as intellectually. This is a USP of our institute. Our institute, which is top institutes in Mumbai, you can say that mentality. We prepare students mentally. This is our USP. Apart from giving them content and giving them intellectual or giving them, you can say, intellectual content and all. Fine. Then, so see, UPSC is not only about IAS, IPS and all those things. There are many different services also available in UPSC. There are 24 different posts available. First, understand what is this, because if you are only blindly studying now, you will not be getting a direction. First, get the direction and then study. See what you do. Suppose if you want to travel from Kulabad to suppose Dadar, what you will be doing first? If you want to travel from Kulabad to Dadar, what you will be doing? Will you be randomly sitting into any train? Okay, I think this train is good. I should sit into this train, and this train will leave me to Dadar. Will it happen like this? No. What you need to do? You need to first purchase a ticket of Dadar train. You need to first purchase a ticket of Dadar station from Kulaba, and then via that ticket, you'll be sitting into a proper train, which is actually going in that direction, and then you'll be reaching your destination. So direction is very important. The problem in today's youth is they are very, very much exciting. They get excited very easily, and that's why suicides and all those things are happening. So first, it is important to become mentally fit. Okay, so first get the directions and then think about the studies, and for that we are here. So there are 24 different posts PSC, and group B services are also there. You can see group B services. The next slide is all about coming about the group B services. Fine. So UPSC, okay, you are getting an all India ranking, a good all India ranking, then you'll be getting IPS, IRS officer, then Indian Foreign Services and all those things you'll be getting. So you understood? So 24 different posts are available, group A services and group B services. Next slide is loading. Now, apart from that, again, important thing is motivation. See, students, problem is that you should be motivated. Motivation is a prime aspect. Without motivation, you cannot exceed in your career. So for motivation, I'm typing some names. You need to go through their life. IAS Smita, Sabharwal. I'm typing this name. Okay. In chat box, you can see the name IAS Smita Sabharwal. Okay. Now the slide is loaded. So IAS Smita Sabharwal, first of all, think about the success stories. Don't think that, okay, I know I am the king. I know everything. I'll be just reading the books and I'll be going through the civil services. It doesn't end like this. First, go through the success stories. The people from the rural area are cracking this examination. So for that, you need to understand what is a success story, in what conditions they have studied the examination. Okay, so okay, not about those people, but at least you learn about those people. IAS Smita Sabharwal, you just have a view. It will give you motivation. Kiran Bedi, I don't want to, I don't need to tell you that Kiran Bedi, everyone knows about the Kiran Bedi and the great things she has done for the nation. And then Arvind Kejriwal, although he is a politician now, but he has started his career as an IRS officer. So read about those success stories. Then you'll be getting motivation. Then you'll be, then your mind will get prepared for this examination. And then your vision will become for this examination. Okay. Then I hope I'm getting to your expectations now. Whatever you wanted, that content, that I'm delivering that content now. Okay. So you need to have patience. Within some 15-20 minutes, you cannot expect that within 15-20 minutes, we can talk everything about the UPSC. It will not happen like this. For seeing a movie, you spend at least 2 to 3 hours and then you get the result of that movie. And here we are talking about the civil services examination. So 15 minutes, you cannot expect that we can deliver everything. You need to have patience. Okay. So next part is that another name is there. Okay. So that eligibility criteria and all those things is you, it is easily available on Google. It is easily available on our website, youngias.com. I have taken the content from that website only. So I will be just telling it in brief. You need to have a graduation from a recognized UGC or AICTE approved university. Up to the age of 32 years, you can give this examination. And for that, you need to read notification. Okay. Every year it may not be same. Notification may change every year. You need to read through the notification and then you need to go for the exam. Okay. Relaxation is there for reserve caste candidates. Okay. So this is about the eligibility criteria for UPSC. Then, what kind of study you need to do in UPSC examination? So of course, as shown you already, there are three paper patterns. Now you need to pay attention because now I'm talking about the paper pattern. Okay. So preliminary, mains and interview. This is a three paper patterns available in UPSC examination. Okay. So pre-examination. Pre-examination is for filtration purpose. And which is that a paper which will be which will make the filtration of the student is CSAT paper. Civil Service Aptitude Test. It is a qualifying in nature. For UPSC examination, this paper is qualifying, where you need to have, you need to qualify that paper. You need to get a 66%. You need to get 33% marks in this examination. That is 66 marks out of 200. Then and then only your GS paper will be checked. So first your CSAT paper will be checked. Then if you are qualifying the CSAT paper, your general studies paper will be checked. And students, believe me, you don't have to worry about CSAT paper. If you are with us, we ensure that you just attend the CSAT lectures and you can qualify into the CSAT paper. You just need to be regular in lectures, because see, ultimately some benefit should happen, right? If you are joining with us, we will give you insurance. We will assure you that you don't have to study much for your CSAT paper. We are here to take care of your CSAT. You pass on that burden on our head. We will be ensuring you that, okay, you will be getting not 33%, at least 50% marks you will be getting into the CSAT examination, because it is not too much difficult to get 50% marks. Okay. So that assurance, you understand, no institute will assure like this. We are assuring that, okay, you will be getting that minimum 33% that qualifying nature. No one from our institute will be, it will happen with them that, okay, you are not qualified into the CSAT paper. It will never happen. And it has never happened in last so many years since this paper has been qualifying in nature. Okay. So you need to learn a lot about the GS, general studies. You need to learn a lot about that. Okay. So what comes under the GS? GS, you can see what will be coming into the GS. You can understand. General studies. Whatever you are learning from your school, there will be the general studies paper. So you can say that history, geography, polity, science, economics, current affairs, constitution, panchayat raj, all the things are there. It's a very informative subject. And to teach that subject, there are so many faculties who are actually learning those subjects since last 2 to 3 decades. Those people are learning. Some people have already worked in the civil services as officers. Those people will be coming and interacting with you. We have a trend, our A. Shah Institute has one trend that bureaucrats directly come and interact with you. those who are already doing that civil services, or those who are already active into the state and civil services career, they will be interacting with you generally Saturdays and Sundays. So this is a great learning point. Okay, and this is all about the syllabus for preliminary examination. Next. So whatever you are learning till your 10th standard and NCERT books, and you can say whatever your board books are there, NCERT books are there, CBSE books are there, you need to integrate all those knowledge, and then UPSC syllabus you can cover via that. See, then mains examination, it is already available on our website, so I will not be much talking about that. And I think there are some upcoming webinars also. So in that upcoming webinars also, you'll be getting the insights on the mains examination. But only one thing I would like to tell, that UPSC mains is a subjective kind of examination where you need to write. And for writing, you need to have a content in your head. If the content is not there in your head, you cannot write it. And from where the content will be coming? See, it is an input and output process. Input will be your content, your newspaper, your books, your publications. We'll be telling you about those publications. That will be your input, and then output will be what you're writing into the examination, what you're writing into that answer sheet. Okay, that will be your output. So reading is must. Without reading, see, there are not going to be essays like Rainy Day, and you can say My School Life and all, such kind of essays there will not be coming into the exam, where you can just randomly write anything. Essays will be coming on a very lively topics, very burning issues into the society. For that, the content should be there. And for content, reading habits is very important. Okay. Then only one thing I would like to tell, that UPSC mains examination, you can give in your own language also. In your mother tongue, you can give UPSC mains examination. Hindi is there, Sindhi is there, Gujarati is there. I think this slide is there. There are many languages are there. Marathi, you can give UPSC mains examination. Gujarati is there, and many, around 20 different languages are there. So language is not a barrier. Language is not a barrier in UPSC examination. Your education qualification is not a barrier. If you are from a commerce background, from arts background, from engineering background, from science background, from management background, from hotel management background, from computer background, it will not matter into the UPSC examination, because there are many optional subjects are also available. If you are from a management background, you can take management subject. If you are from a science background, you can take physics, chemistry, biology subject. If you are from engineering background, you can select mechanical engineering and civil engineering. If you are from a commerce background, you can select commerce subject. 500 marks are there for optional paper. You can select two optional papers out of the so many optional subjects available. So UPSC is taking care of your education background. UPSC is taken care is taking care of your language. So there is equal opportunity for all the students. There is equal opportunity for all the students. So you need to take care of this. Fine. Yeah. So understand that language is not a barrier, optional subjects. This is the important slide I wanted to tell. Then let's talk about the interview now. Now many people talk that, sir, what will come into the interview? See, definitely we give a consistent basis interview training in our sessions. Also the experts come. From you can say we have some experts in Delhi, and who are retired civil services officers from state government. We have some officers along with us. So those officers will be coming, and in this format your interview will be conducted. See, this is a format, the interview conduction format. There is not a single person who will be taking your interview. There will be a panel, and who in the interview, in the interview panel, there will be chairman, member, and chairman and members will be. But two members will be sitting beside the chairman, who will be asked the cross questions. What is the duty of a chairman? Chairman will be asking you the direct questions. Chairman is a very cool person. He will be only asking you, okay, tell me what is your hobby. That is a straightforward single question chairman will be asking. And then members will be asking the cross question. If you tell that, okay, sir, reading is my hobby, then those members will be cross questioning to you. Okay, reading is your hobby. Tell me what kind of books you have you read. Who is your favorite author? What is your favorite content? Okay, then what you do with that reading? Do you apply the reading in your life? Such kind of questions, you can say question sets, they will be cross questioning you. And a moment will come where you will be shut, where your mouth will be shut. That moment will be coming. Those members will be cross questioning at that extent. Then there are other two members where you can say that near the candidate, there are other two members who will be observing your body language, who will be observing your body language, your gesture and posture. See, ultimately, as a civil servant, as a civil service officers, your body language matters a lot. See, now COVID is coming. COVID is going on. Lockdown is going on. What is the language? If the language of your municipal officer there is IAS officers for that into the district. So you can say district collector is there, CEO of a municipal corporation is there. So if their body language is known, how you will be feeling? So definitely body language is important in that whatever bureaucrats are there. As a bureaucrat, your body language matters a lot. So start improving your body language from today itself. Your spine should be straight. Your head should be balanced. Your shoulder should be, you can say, shoulder should be at a proper position. And you will be, and your body language should not be a defensive and a very coward type of body language. A very dilute kind of body language. It should not happen like that. A person should feel motivated. A person should feel energetic just after looking towards you. That should be your body language. Okay. So all those things we teach you in the soft skills. Okay. And it is important that see, if you are a 12th pass out, now if you are a 12th pass out, if you are a first year student, then it is very easy to learn the new things. If you're already graduate and after graduation, 1 or 2 years have been happened, then it will be very difficult because you have become rigid. Okay. So that's why we recommend that you start preparing for UPSC or civil services examination from your 11th standard or from your 12th standard examination. After your 12th standard, first year, second year, okay, you start preparing. At least if you are in college, start preparing for this examination because it will be easy to grasp those changes into you. Whatever we want to make you, it will be easy for you to become that ideal personality. Okay, then. So that is all about the interview. After interview, that was all about the UPSC. Doubts and all we'll be taking. But before that, again, I told you that motivation stories are very important. The first motivation story is Ira Singhal. You read about those people. What Ira Singhal has done in her life. If you Google her picture, okay. After this webinar, you just Google Ira Singhal. Her height is around 3 feet, 3.5 feet is her height, and her body is completely deformed body. Okay, and she has got many struggles. You can just read about her stories. Even she was not permitted to have a work into that government system. Due to her physical handicap situation, but even if she was physically handicapped, she cracked the UPSC examination. She cracked the UPSC examination with All India Ranking 1. She cracked the UPSC examination with All India Ranking 1 straightforward in 2015. You read about her. So next motivation story. Another motivation story. Can you tell me the name of that particular guy? A boy-like person is there in front of the that car. Can you tell me the name? Yeah, Ansar Sheikh. No, not a question mark. You should be have conviction. Ansar Sheikh. So you should read about Ansar Sheikh. He was from a district like Jalna. He was from a poor family background. His father is an auto repair. He was from a Jalna where there is no water. Very drought affected Maharashtra. Okay, so. If you are reading about those people now, you will understand how many resources those people were bearing resources with them. But the part was Ansar Sheikh has started preparing for UPSC examination. He's after his 12th standard examination. Officially, it is after 12, but I know that he has much before that. And he qualified UPSC in first attempt. This is his USP. See, Smita Sabharwal and Ansar Sheikh, there is little bit change in their records. Smita Sabharwal is the youngest lady IAS officer and Ansar Sheikh is the youngest IAS officer who has cracked the UPSC examination in first attempt. Then how, and that's why our concept is there, young IAS. That's why our brand is there, young IAS brand. Why? Because we want that you should crack UPSC in your first attempt. That's why we have created this brand called as young IAS, which is there, especially it is there for after 10th students, after 12th and undergraduate students. So if you start preparing from your early stage, you can crack UPSC examination Ansar Sheikh in your first attempt. Okay, so that is our basic funda behind young IAS. Again, Tina Dabi is there. She was from a rich family background. So you can see that there are diverse kind of people. There are variety of people who are qualifying the UPSC examination. Those who are rich, those who are poor, all those people are qualifying, giving this examination, right? Then apart from that, of course, see, every year topper, you should have a information about the toppers. There is a topper called as Gaurav Agarwal and he writes amazing blogs and you should read his blogs. You should read its content. And that's why I told you that our website is, I can say, number one website, because we have got so much of content in our website. Okay, so that was all about the UPSC and MPSC. Within 5 minutes, I'll be telling, because MPSC and UPSC preliminary examination is almost same. And why I'm talking about the MPSC, because if your dream is to become deputy collector, if your dream is to become collector, you can become collector via MPSC examination also. How? That is a question mark. Okay, if you want to become IPS officer, but you cannot become IPS officer via UPSC examination, you can become IPS officer via MPSC. Many people don't know about that. And if you had a patience, you will be getting this information. How? See, you will be giving MPSC examination, class one examination you'll be giving. Its preliminary examination is almost same as UPSC. Its paper pattern is 100% same as UPSC. You search it in a Google, you will say, sir, what you are telling, MPSC is a different exam, UPSC is a different exam. Yes, the examination is different, but the preliminary examination is 100% same paper pattern and syllabus. More questions are asked on the MPSC. More questions are asked on Maharashtra in MPSC examination. This is a little bit difference. So I would always recommend, we always recommend that, okay, if you are preparing for UPSC examination, you give state services exam also. In Maharashtra, it is MPSC. In Gujarat, it will be Gujarat State Service Public Service Commission examination. Uttar Pradesh, every state has its own State Service Public Service Commission examination. Okay, so we would recommend that you go for UPSC as well as you go for state examinations, state civil service exams. Okay, because syllabus, there is not much difference. History, geography, politics, science, economics, mathematics, logic, English, all the subjects are going to remain same. Only little bit difference in mains examination. Preliminary, there is not much difference, but mains, there will be the difference. UPSC mains is definitely a different exam because it is a subjective kind of exam and lot of content is required. Okay, so if your dream is to become civil service, if your dream is to get the same thing into the state services, if you want to get that, or if you want to serve into the central government, then you can give MPSC examination. You can become deputy collector. After 4 to 5 years of sincere service and good performance, best performance, you can be promoted on the post of collector. You can become deputy superintendent of police, and after that you can say that you give a proper service. See, you know, Vishwas Nangre Patil is one of the example. He was into the state police services and then he promoted as an IPS officer. Okay, MPSC, there are some newspaper questions we'll be taking at the end. Definitely I'll be addressing all of your questions. Then let me just give you what is required. And another thing is that many students think that, sir, MPSC Marathi is required. It is not so, students. MPSC preliminary examination, English as well as Marathi papers are there. In English, the same question will be there in English. So if you are preparing for UPSC exam, you can give MPSC because questions will be there in English language and you can obviously tackle that. And in mains, there is a paper called as Marathi, which was very difficult paper to crack for the non-Marathi people. But now since 2016, that even that Marathi paper has become very easy and it is qualifying in nature. But same like CSAT, you can say 33% marks were required in UPSC. Same for Marathi, 40% marks are required. In that Marathi paper, if 40% you are getting, then your GS papers, GS 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever there is in MPSC mains, that subjects will be checked. So, but that is not a challenge. We take care of your Marathi. Every week we give Marathi lectures to our students, so that will be taken care of. Okay, but and especially for girls, okay, whoever girls are here, please pay attention. In Maharashtra government, you have got 33% reservation. You have got 33% reservation in Maharashtra services. Maharashtra government officer, you can become with 33% reservation. Your challenge, your competition is not with the boys. Your competition is with all the female category. Okay, so you should take its opportunity. I see many girls, you are compromising with your career for your, you can say, marriage, for your in-laws, and all those things happens and you just struggle in your life. So it should not help you. And I can challenge you, MPSC is the best examination for you if you are from a female category, because you have got the reservation. Of course, you can keep UPSC as a goal, but little bit easy way if you want to do, if you want to serve the nation and if you want to serve the country. See, ultimately state is a part of country. So your goal will be fulfilled. Your theme, you get your theme. So you should think of UPSC examination, okay? Then there are some posts in MPSC, Tahsildar, Nayab Tahsildar, Deputy Collector, Block Development Officer, Finance. All those are some state level posts which are actually into the state, right? Newspaper, Lok Sabha newspaper is good. Then you say Maharashtra Times newspaper is good for MPSC preparations, right? Lok Sabha and Maharashtra Times, you can remember the names, right? Then, of course, I talk about the paper pattern, exactly same for MPSC. See, general studies and aptitude, again, same paper pattern, same number of marks. So there is absolutely no difference as far as preliminary examination is concerned, except that only some questions will be there on Maharashtra. Couple of questions will be there on Maharashtra in your GS paper, right? Then, see, syllabus for MPSC, again, same. I'm talking about a state level, state civil services, group A level. Not about group B, group C. Group B, that is police service inspector, sales tax officer, Mantralaya officer, there they are having some different paper pattern and different syllabus. I'm talking about the group A, where you will be getting, where you will be becoming deputy superintendent of police, deputy, you can say collector, for both. Almost you can check it on Google, both the syllabus are same. Only you can see here that Maharashtra, well, this shall reference to Maharashtra, that will be the differentiation factor in MPSC. This is a mains paper pattern. I would be telling you that MPSC mains is an objective kind of examination. What is the difference in UPSC mains and MPSC mains? That MPSC mains is objective kind of examination, where you need to, again, there will be the options. Unlike UPSC mains, UPSC mains is subjective, where you need to write, but MPSC mains is objective kind of examination. Okay, then, so syllabus and all is available. So I am not telling you, and that syllabus is going to change. Okay, there are not much differences, but government has announced that there are some different syllabus. Of course, I want to tell you that if you are preparing for UPSC examination, you can give other examination also. That is why these slides are there. You can give a staff selection examination, you can give railway examination, Indian Army, Navy, Air Force, CDS examination, you can crack if you are preparing for UPSC. So your preparation for UPSC will never be wasted. If you are preparing for UPSC, it will never be wasted. First of all, you will become a very, you can say, civilians of India than a normal people. You will be definitely become much better than at least 1 lakh people if you are preparing, if you are just for this syllabus. Because it is said that education prepares your personality also. So definitely you will be having a very, you can say, a very positive personality, very powerful personality if you are preparing for this exam. And of course, if you are not getting selected into those exams, then you can give an exam and you get selected. Those things you can give. Right, newspaper I have told, Lok Sabha and Maharashtra Times you can read for MPSC examination, right? Next, so talking about our brand now. So first, what is your first thing to do after going home? You just have a view on our website, Young IAS. Lots of information is there. Content, see, today content is a thing. How you can crack UPSC examination, it will depend what kind of content you are exposed to. And you will be getting the best content out of our website. And some content we have not put on our website, that is a core content about the mains examination and all, that you will be getting in our training programs, right? So content is a king, and I'm definitely sure that you will be getting best content from me. And that is very much evident from our website itself. You can see so much of content is available, statistics is available on our website. Why I'm repeating this? Because I want you to visit that website, right? Then, yeah, next slide is coming. Any questions you have, you can just put it in a chat box, and then I'll be talking. Apart from that, we also talk about what is our USP. See, our USP is that we also give you training. As I told you earlier, we prepare your mindset. Okay, we prepare your mindset first. See, what happens in most of the coaching classes is that once you join the coaching class, they start bombarding you with the lectures, syllabus, study material and all. Of course, we will be giving it to you, but we will be preparing your mentality. We will be programming your mind for UPSC and civil services preparations. Can you tell me, I am asking you one question. Why people like Ira Singhal, people like Ansar Sheikh, people from a poor family background gets qualified into the UPSC, and why people like you don't get qualified into the UPSC? That is a survey. That people who are struggling with their life, they get selected into such examination, and people who are not struggling with their life, they generally don't get selected in those exams. What is the reason behind that? Can you tell me? Yes. Yeah, notification will be giving it to you. All the PDF notifications will be getting into the group upsc.gov.in or employmentnews.com. नोटिफिकेशन मिल जाएगा एंड स्टूडेंट्स जस्ट टाइप इन गूगल पीडीएफ नोटिफिकेशन फॉर यूपीएससी एग्जामिनेशन पीडीएफ नोटिफिकेशन फॉर यूपीएससी फुल ऑफ रिजल्ट्स ओके सो लोडेड Yeah, sir, as each year, approximately 1500 officers are selected. So what about the previously working officers? You see, retirement is there, na? Previous officer will get retired every year. See, there is one specific numbers. Around, you can say 1200, 1500 number there. So those previous officers will be retired every year. Every year, retirement is that, say, it's a very futuristic question. Okay, you got the answer for okay. Now, see pre-IAS foundation course. This is a very nice, you can say, young IAS concept is here. See, I already talked about the motto. The motto was pre-IAS foundation course is to make it possible for the candidates to qualify civil services in the first attempt, like Ansar Sheikh. That is our motto behind that, and that is our vision behind that, and that is how the strategy behind that course is there, right? Then. So what is the saline features of our young IAS course? You can say holidays. See, your college studies and our platform will be integrated properly. You will not feel burden. In fact, these studies will be helping you in your college studies. Okay, you will not feel the burden, but our this program will be helping you in your college studies. Value added daily online programs will be there. Current affairs lecture will be there. Online live test will be there. Some video recordings will be there. Then in the text format, content format, blogging will be blogs will be there. All those, yeah, that is a kind of information you'll be getting daily on our online platform. It's a very strong online platform Asia has on the web portal, right? NCRT, see, problem is that many people don't take NCRT into their lectures, but we do take NCRT syllabus from the basic in our lectures. We assume that. The way to assume that you are from a ground level, you are from a zero level. That way my webinar has been designed today. In the same way our lectures are designed. You will never get any lecture bouncer on your head. Because we will be taking care that you are preparing from the zero. You are preparing from the basic. That care we will be taking. Right? And the best online live platform. See, our online platform, we have a special software. We are not using Google Meets. We are not using Zoom and all those softwares. We have our special software designed by ourselves, which is an excellent software. You can have a view. We are just using this software where you will get feeling of a live lectures. You are not interacting with me, but you can interact with me directly via voice and via chat box. Okay. So the best online platform, I can say, mobile application also. We have mobile application is very, is also very informative, same as our website. So this is all about our online course. On the basis of 12th standard, if you are undergraduate, this is all about our online course. 3 years foundation course is there. That is for young IAS. And fee structure, all the saline features I have already talked to you. Already I have talked about those saline features. All the features will be there. Fee structure, information you will get. Generally, the fee structure is 25,000 for first year. From second year, it will be classroom lectures. First year, it is going to be online lectures in this form. Okay, you will be also given lecture recordings on your demand. It is not like that you are not attending the lectures and that lectures is missed like physical lectures. It is not so. If you are missing those lectures, you just have to request. You need to produce the reason behind your absence. We will be giving the video recording to you. Okay, that challenge you will be taking. So all the things are available. Content is available. Web portal is available. Resources are available. Library. Hardly you can say any institute will be having that institute. So that's the biggest library. And yes, will be getting. Yes. So that was of the undergraduate course. And for graduate, there is, you can say, Atmanirbhar Bharat. That coin, that term we have coined, Atmanirbhar Bharat. Because we have applied to the students in a very less fees. See, UPSC fees generally crosses 1 lakh. But only online people are giving 2 lakh. But because of the pandemic situation, people modules with them. So for considering that, we have designed this policy called as Atmanirbhar Bharat with student support scheme. We are supporting the students literally. And this is for graduate students. First year, the fees is, you can say 25,000 is the fees for complete online coaching will be there. And the demo lectures are going to start. Demo lectures have already started. So you can opt to sit into the demo lectures, and you will get to know the high quality lectures and lectures full of content from our faculties. Okay, then. So this is the, you can see, platform. We have designed it in a very strategic. Extra things we are giving. What are the extra things we are giving? See, why our students get selected into the civil services? Because we are giving them something extra, which other people in the market are not giving. And literally, MPSC, UPSC classes have become a market nowadays. But even if the market is there, you can say the students get selected from specific brands. Is one of those brands. Because we can mindfulness, from my webinar, it is evident that we give more focus on mindfulness coaching. We give mind programming also. We program your mind for your civil services preparations. We give memory techniques. I'll be telling you about memory techniques in brief. Soft skills also we give, your body language, gesture, posture, your personality development. That training is also given by the professionals. Open doubt solving at the end of lecture. See, even if it is an online platform, you will be getting open doubt solving at the end of every lecture. You can ask absolutely any question at the end of that lecture and your answer will be given. And then exhaustive content. See, content, we are king in content. I can definitely tell you, you will not get such kind of content anywhere. From all over India, the content from the best faculties is with us. And you will be getting that content. See, problem, what is the problem in UPSC? UPSC problem is that for UPSC mains, people are not getting the content. What is the problem in MPSC? For MPSC mains, people are not getting the content. They are getting the lectures, but they are not getting the content. But here, we assure you that you will be getting content for all those platforms. Right? And trust of the brands. Of course, our brand is there. You can search it in a Google. Top three, our brands will be there. Okay? Then. So that is all about this. So see, and memory techniques, we give the training. And so slides are taking time. So memory techniques is exclusive thing in our training program. You can ask me your doubts now. You can ask me your doubts. I think that is the end of the webinar. And whatever you want to ask, you can interact with the number. I'm just going through the slides. Such kind of memory techniques training we also give, which will be actually helping you in your examination preparation. See, you might be knowing that students from North India, just go through this slide. I'm not explaining those slides. Students from North India get selected into the civil services. Why it is so? Can you tell me the reason? Why is from North India, percentage of the students from North India is more into the civil services? All the Mishras and all the Kumars are there. What is the reason behind that? Can you tell me in the chat box? Yes. Why the percentage from North India is more, UP, Bihar and all those area is more Delhi and not from the Mumbai into the civil services? Why it is so? I'm waiting for your answers. Yes, all the people are typing. Good. See, the best one thing is that in their education system, memory techniques are imbibed in their education system. Yeah, hardworking, consistency is there. Okay. Hardworking, consistency is there. See, those are the memory techniques which we talk about in our lectures. History, geography, politics, science, economics. In a month, we conduct some memory sessions from the guests. And in that case, you will be getting exposed to the memory techniques, how to use memory techniques in your core subjects. That is a USP which we are giving. And that is the reason why people from the North India are getting selected. The mindset is there, hardworking, consistency is there. But memory techniques students, memory techniques is what? Which North Indian, there is a culture of memory techniques. And that culture is not there into the Mumbai or Maharashtra. So if you are using memory techniques in your, in your daily preparations, you can easily crack UPSC examination. Because a lot of content is to memorize. So ultimately, memory is playing a huge role into your UPSC mains. Okay. So for UPSC mains as well as in preliminary, for remembering the content, memory techniques are going to help you. And I'm just telling via my slides that what are the methods we use in our memory techniques. You can say mnemonics is there. Acronyms, acrostics are there, mind programming is there, such kind of memory techniques we use, body mnemonics are there. So you can, these are the acronyms, you can say VIBGYOR, PAR, PANIC and BODMAS, such kind of memory techniques are there, which will be relating with each and every subject, GS subject. Yeah, any other doubts? This is an example of acrostics. Right? Yeah, any other doubts till the... So within 2 minutes, we'll be wrapping up the webinar. Okay, so understand our exclusivity. Okay, now can you quickly, that is the last question of today's session. See, Maharashtra is there at the center. So can you tell me the names of the peripheral districts, peripheral states of Maharashtra, starting from this? You need to tell me in the clockwise direction. This, and last one. Can you just type it in the chat box? Maharashtra, clockwise direction, peripheral states in Maharashtra. Above one, after that, and after that. On the boundary of Maharashtra. Gujarat, okay. First one is Gujarat. Then, next one. I know most of you might be knowing, but I want to tell you that how we can use memory techniques for geography. And that is the way of our teaching. That is a USP. Not Uttar Pradesh, sorry. Not Uttar Pradesh. No. No Rajasthan. Guys, it is horrible. You need to prepare yourself. Yeah, Madhya Pradesh is the correct answer. I thought many of you have already expertise into that, but I can see that. Okay, but we are here to prepare you. We are here to start with the basics. Then after Madhya Pradesh, come on. What is this state? See at my that point. Red point you see. Yes. After Madhya Pradesh, come on. What are the answers after Madhya Pradesh? Chhattisgarh, very good. Then after Chhattisgarh, there is a Chhattisgarh. Yeah, after Chhattisgarh. Telangana, good. After Telangana, Karnataka, and last Goa. See, now how we can be memorizing it with the help of memory techniques. You can say that suppose Maharashtra, I am giving the name of some Maharaj. Suppose some Maharaj is there. Okay, some Maharaj is there. A royal person is there. He needs to enjoy his life. So a Maharaj is there. A king is there. Then Maharaj is Gujarat. So Gujarat, I am making a distortion in a memory technique. Gujarat, I am distorting it as a Rath. So Maharaj, king at Rath. Rath, understand a little bit Hindi. Rath in night. Then there is a Chhattisgarh. So in Rath, he had Madhya Pradesh, MP. So he need to have a beverage. He want to have a drink. He need to have a, and in Sanskrit, it is called as Madhya. So Maharaj, Rat, Madhya. See the story we are making, and that is the way we talk, we teach some of our GA subjects in our memory technique session. So Maharaj, Rat, Madhya, how many rupees he paid for the Madhya? 36 rupees, because it is Chhattisgarh. Chhattis means 36. So 36 rupees he paid. Then he Telangana. Generally people mixes water into the alcohol, but what he is mixing? He is mixing tail means oil, into the water. See, it is funny, why? Because it is a human mind to memorize. Your study, if you make your study weird, if you can make your study funny, then you can memorize it easily. Chhattisgarh, Telangana, he is mixing tail, that is oil. Then he started doing natak. So after having alcohol, started doing that, then we told that, okay, if you want to do natak, if you want to enjoy your life, go into the. So Maharashtra, you can say Gujarat, 30, then Madhya Pradesh, Madhya, that is alcohol, Madhya Pradesh, then it was 36 rupees, Chhattisgarh, then it was tail, that is oil, Telangana, then it was Natak, that was Karnataka, and finally, please go into the Goa. So go. So that way memory techniques we use. Very funny thing, you will be enjoying the memory technique session as well as all the GA session. You will be getting a nice content from all of us. And thank you very much for attending this webinar. Any doubts you have, you can directly ask me in last 2 minutes, or we can wrap up this webinar. Okay, thank you. Any doubts? Definitely another sessions are coming tomorrow. There will be one session, I guess. You will be getting a schedule. You can ask the doubts in upcoming sessions also, right? So did you understood how I cannot to I can? Rational things are there. I had told you that step. Okay, I told you those steps. I cannot, I will not, I want to do, how I can do this, and then it starts opening simultaneously. So that journey from I cannot to I can, you should understand that the ladder I had, that special PPT, the special image I had, you need to memorize that special image. Okay, fine. So all those things you'll be getting on your WhatsApp. Okay, all those questions related to your studies, books and all, we have a separate PDF for that, you'll be getting on your WhatsApp group. Okay, so thank you students for your patience. And thank you for attending. And please have a patience. If you have patience, you can crack any civil services examinations. Thank you. Thank you, students.